short form of it board. As I was saying yesterday, that there are five, six basic parts of short form of it. The first was the person we are writing to, right? As we have said, first we will write submitted to, then submitted by, then subject and fine. So obviously it is something like the title page of the main long report. And the next step was, after this submission, this and that, there was methodology. Methodology actually meant what? The procedure, the sources. It means how we have collected all that, right? What methods were used, as I have said earlier there. Methodology might be something like interview technique. It can be something like questionnaire method. Right, we can apply observation method or something like that, whatever. And it might be online sources. And as I said earlier, that it would be something like one paragraph or so. Right? Just to make it clear, how did we collect all that? So what was our procedure? And the next was, what? After methodology? Before that, before methodology, I mentioned one thing, that was intro. Can you recall? Before it, better go for it. Intro, as we have discussed earlier, it means what? Expansion of the above mentioned things, like submitted to, submitted by, subject and date. You just dilate upon that, elaborate that a bit, and that would become your intro. And once again, intro is of something like one page or so, one paragraph or so. Because intro means intro something like that. Okay. And often this is the main thing actually, what we call report, that is finding. Sometimes students do what? There is a time for findings. Instead of writing findings, they just say, I have missed one point, and that was findings. And findings actually the whole stuff. Findings actually mean the whole report. So they say, I have missed one point, and that was findings. Otherwise my report was okay. How you can score good marks? So findings means the report itself. So this is the pivot of that, this is the main stuff. The whole report actually means findings. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Findings, how we do, how we write findings. We start in this fashion that the findings of the report are as follows. Right? And then we start writing finding number one, two, three. What do you think? Do we use headings or not? Do we use headings? Yes. In short form of report, do we use headings or not? In short form of report, headings are a must. Right? They're a must in short form of report. There are some reports in which headings are optional. Suppose there is a report called memorandum report. We will discuss later. In memorandum report, headings are optional. And in other reports, like letter report, right, headings, there are no headings. And it's a fair question, right, that headings are a must in short formal report. Heading might or might not be there in case of memorandum report. And there are no headings in case of letter report. So we can write headings, right? We usually go for four, five headings, right? As per requirement, it depends on the situation. Four, five headings are there. So suppose it depends on the topic actually. Suppose you have to write some report about the current, right, political crisis in our country. So headings might be something like that. Suppose you say the first heading might be response of the teenagers, response of the old politicians, reaction of the women folk. Are you getting? So what do you say? So we make four, five headings, and then we, in each heading, we write one paragraph or so. So headings are, we go on changing headings as per situation. four, five headings are there. And as I've said, the findings means the whole discussion, the whole report. So sometimes, instead of findings, we use the word discussion. The whole stuff, right? But commonly, this is the case. And findings must be, what should be the average length of findings? What do you think? Because if the whole report is of 2 to 5 pages, in routine, the report is of 2 to 3 pages. So findings means something like 1.5 pages or so. Okay? One paragraph for this, one for this, and the remaining stuff is findings, right? Generally, it comes to something like 1.5 paragraphs. Okay? And findings can be written in different ways, right? Finding number one, this. Suppose if there are more headings, so then we can write first Roman words, then one, then two, then A, B, C. But if there's a short report, it's not the case. In case of short report, we just write, put the heading at the top, and then we go on discussing all that. Clear?
Yes.
Got it?
Yeah. Yes.
And what next? As there's, you were asking that, right? There is submitting. Summary is also called synopsis. Another word for it is abstract. They are almost the same. These three things are almost the same, but they are not 100% the same. Almost. But they are interchangeable in a way. Okay? And what's meant by summary? Yasin, what do we write in summary?
For last time.
Summary means abstract of that, abridgment of that. Crux of that, right? Nutshell of that. So as I alluded yesterday, that in summary we do what? We just summarize the things mentioned over here. It means whatever we have discussed over there, we will just jot down the key points, just the crux of that. Suppose, right, people say that political crisis is because of corrupt politicians. Some say it is because of pride, unemployment. Some say it's because of some other factor. In summary, we will write something like this, right? Corruption of the politicians, lack of responsibility of the general public, right? Unemployment, continuous inflation, and overall unrest in the country are the causes of this. So this is the summary. Okay. And another thing, there is something like summary, but there is not summary, that's called conclusion. Have you any idea what the difference between summary and conclusion, Mr. Malai? Conclusion is, it is something like summary, but it's not summary. And people think that summary means conclusion, conclusion means summary. It's not the case. Conclusion, as you can guess from the very name of it, that conclusion is that when you listen to something, and we say, here, what's your conclusion? Suppose I say, right, in 2013, GC students, right, got first position in such and such exam, right? In 14, KIPS got this position. In, suppose, 15, FC. In 16, 17, 18, once again GC. So what is your conclusion? Who is at number one in performance? So obviously we say GC.
And that's not the same.
So this is sort of conclusion. No, it, I was just saying, right, whatever. Yeah? No, right, no admittance. So conclusion means sort of evaluation. Conclusion is sort of subjective opinion, sort of evaluation on the basis of given facts. Hamza, are you listening?
Yes, sir.
Or are you just paying more attention to something different? So this is conclusion. And the most important thing in report writing is what we call recommendation. Recommendation. This is the key point, actually. So you can guess very easily, recommendation is what? Anyone? Recommendation stand for, Ms. Sarang, what? Danish. Recommendation means that, because it's very easy to find out that this is the problem. The main thing is how to find solution of it. So recommendation basically means, on the basis of all these things, what do you suggest? What measures can be taken to overcome this problem? These are recommendations. Recommendation means what to do. The main problem in throughout at global level is what? This is the problem that all of us know this is our problem, this is our problem, but no one knows what steps need to be taken to tackle that thing, to grapple with that thing. So recommendation means, suppose in the recommendation we write something like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we say, if we take these measures, so this problem can be solved. Suppose you say, recommendation number one, it depends on the topic, on the title of that. Suppose, first of all, we need to be very careful that we should take right measures to overcome the curb the problem of unemployment. If unemployment is not there, there will be least chance of corruption, sure. Suppose you say, from the very childhood, we should write, right? Upbringing of kids should be in such a fashion that when they grow up, they become good citizens. So whatever, it means these are practical measures. Recommendation means solution of that. Suggestions, measures, and recommendations should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It depends. So once again, it is something like half page or so, sometimes one page. But this is the pivot of all that. The most important thing in the whole report is this. Right? Because everyone knows, right, there is sort of, God forbid, our corruption in Pakistan, right? But the thing is, how to control this thing? What steps need to be taken to curb it? Everyone say, yeah, we are this and that, but you say, okay, what is the solution? So these are recommendations. So recommendations are part of every report, or they are, might or might not be there. Recommendations are part of analytical reports. Right? Analytical reports in which make sort of analysis. But in case of informational reports, they might or might not be. So this is sort of stuff. Got some ideas though? Inshallah, if there is some problem, we'll discuss in the next day. Thank you.
Inshallah. Thanks.